God.
I don't see what's wrong with it.
How are you going to give your thought life, your heart before God?
As long as you don't I'm not
condemning it.
I know you thought.
But we do have to understand what the Bible says about that, you know?
I have put eternity on every man.
What does it say?
What says a man should not lie with another man? A man should not lie with a man who is with a woman.
It's abomination, isn't it?
God's wrath. You can be glorified.
My ex-family, he was an extreme Protestant Christian. He put his dad on the phone when I started discussing gay marriage. Because I was watching a TV show and had a gay guy on it. And gay marriage came up in the conversation.
Yeah.
And I was saying, if two people love each other, who am I to stand in their way to marry and have be loved? But he got really angry and phoned his dad. And I had this like 60-year-old.
He's a Christian or he's
Christian?
He's Christian, okay.
He had this 60-year-old Northern Irishman screaming down the phone at me, saying, "It's an abomination. It's an abomination." I don't see why it's an abomination.
He's right, but that's not the right attitude.
Oh, believe me.
It's wrong. But, man, that's a crazy way to treat it, you know?
Think about
there are people, I don't know if you've seen a lot of internet, but I've seen stories of men wanting to marry an animal.
That's just weird.
It's wrong, isn't it? I mean, it's plain, obvious wrong, right? Okay, so where's that line? See, the line was made at Adam and Eve. Right? A woman shall leave her family. A woman formed for a man, right?
They were cast out.
And then in the New Testament, a woman shall leave their family and cleave to a husband.
Yeah. The thing is,
and it maintains that line.
It says stand by your wife, but Adam stood by his wife and was chucked out of Eden.
Because why?
Because she was fucking crazy.
No, because she caused him to sin.
No, she sinned. He stood by her like a good husband should.
The sin,
and they were cast out.
The sin falls on Adam. She did it first. Yeah, that's true. But he was over her, not in a mean, slave type way.
I understand.
But he was responsible for her, so he suffered.
Why was he responsible for her?
It was his sin. It was the sin of Adam
Why was he responsible for her?
Here's the thing, right? If you read,
because they were married.
Yeah, and if you read
why was he responsible?
If you read
according
closely,
to way.
Sorry, man. Go.
No, man. I don't want to double up and beat him up.
Sorry, no,
okay.
We don't want to have two guys against one.
We don't do that.
If you read it closely, right? Adam was created and God told him what to do and what not to do.
Man.
And then God created Eve, right?
Yeah.
So, Adam being the man, husband, right, should have told Eve what to do and what not to do.
But
he never did.
Did God not tell her? Why did God not tell her? If God,
I'm sorry, man. What did you say? I'm sorry. I'm zoning.
Yeah, it's all right. You're tired.
I saw a guy that had a Jesus shirt. I didn't know what that was. He looked familiar. So what was?
Sorry, I don't have my T-shirt.
Not you, man.
I have a.
What was the question? Sorry.
If God created Eve, if God created Adam, told him what to do, said these are the rules, blah 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 blah, then he created Eve.
Mm-hmm.
Why did God not tell Eve the rules?
The only answer I can come up with, and it's not biblical because it's like, that's too detailed. Because Adam is over Eve. Adam should have told her. And he did. But God gave us free will. God gave us free will in that garden. And they had the right.
So he
was testing Adam and Eve. And when he commanded them, don't eat of this. You can eat all this, but don't eat of this tree. Eat of this fruit that goes to the tree.
Yeah,
okay? And they disobeyed. She disobeyed. She fed her husband. And then God...